So I think Greg start. It's been about 6 months since we last fished together.
Yeah, all kid.
All kid.
Yeah.
And what's the other one? Little Farriers we love.
Little Farriers last year.
Right, yeah, good time at All Kid.
That was about 12 months ago last year, so yeah. the Little Farriers one. But we're here today, we're at Stickney Brick Pit in Lincolnshire, a really old historical venue. There's some carp in here that are maybe not as old as I am, but certainly as old as you are. And some nice ones as well.
34.
Well, there's a lot of nice carp in here, certainly over 30 years of age anyway. And I think they got to about 38 pounds. So looking at the venue, it looks really nice, very traditional old clay pit in deepest, darkest Lincolnshire. So it's gonna be fun down here, mate. We've got 3 nights of fishing and you've got a bit of a bad stomach at the minute coming back from Turkey, and yeah, so.
Fresh back from Turkey.
It's gonna be a lot of visits to the toilet, I think.
Yeah, I'm in a bit of pain. I'm getting stomach cramps, so.
Oh yeah.
Okay. I'll be all right. A few carp make me better, I reckon.
You need to be in the swim nearest to the toilet then, I reckon.
Yeah.
Right, well, we've got a whole lake to choose from at the moment because it's an exclusive lake booking. This is, we've got the whole lake.
There's quite a few around these reeds, this weed.
A lot of fish, yeah. Yeah, some moving there, mate. But we've got the whole lake to choose from. Any areas you particularly fancy from having walked around?
I don't know. These two swims here.
Yeah.
If we flip a coin on it.
Yeah.
They're both good swims, I think, so.
Well, not Orchid, but when we was at Farriers, you was definitely a gentleman to me, mate, because I came back from France.
Back.
You waited all day to have the first choice to swim. And I remember that. That was proper old school fishing, so.
I think I'm going to return it. You were there at 7 in the evening, wasn't
Yeah, and you was there all day,
I think,
mate.
You robbed that or nothing until you got there.
Yeah, well, I'm going to return the favour now, mate, and be a decent chap back. You've driven a long way. Have first choice to swim, mate. I'm not going to even bother with a draw. I ain't bothered. You get where you
good
want.
Lad, did you? All right, I'll have this weedy one.
Okay, mate.
So I know you fancy that anyway. You've got the old spots for there, ain't you?
No, I fancy this.
You've done your research before you come here.
No,
you're totally blind,
this.
But you knew
I fancy this
before we got here.
This is where we've seen a few more fish. There's a lot more carp in this weed than there is anywhere. At the plateau out in the middle there, apparently that's the spot, so.
It's a lot of weed.
There's nothing in that swim, no weed. There's a few features, but.
I'm going to see myself laying about for a whole day in this bit.
I think you'll get one straight away out of there, mate.
Yeah.
We've seen half a dozen fish in there, so.
I need one.
Yeah.
I've not had a carp in my arms for a while, so.
Well, I'm sure you'll get one, mate, anyway.
Yeah.
Let's go and get the gear and get yourself set up, anyway.
Well, let's go. Let's do it. Just tied a lead on my rod. I'm gonna have a quick lead about. Crow's next door and lead about. There's quite a lot of weed in my swim. I think it's fairly shallow. We'll soon find out. There's a fair few fish in the weed, so I don't want to make too much disturbance, but we could be on for a fish on our first day. So let's get over there, have a little flick about, see what we got. That's the one, I think. That's lovely there. I'm gonna stick it in the clip because I don't want to disturb it too much. There's quite a lot of fish out in this weed bed here, and to be fair, it's really thick. And after that, to the left of it, it's really clear. That's the first time I've cast in the lake, and that's the right result, because I don't want to spook it too much. So we're going to clip that up. We're going to stick a rod on there. I want to put quite a bit of bait out in this open water area. There's a hole in the weed out here, and there's fish in that. So I want to just try and get a single cast into that, not clip it or nothing, and put a few boilies in there. Hopefully we'll get one out of there as well. And then I've got another spot close in, but I've baited that. I'm going to leave that for the night. And hopefully, I think this area right here is a good shout for a bit of bait. Kilo, boilie or so. And then the other two spots, they're just like a handful to try and nick a bite. So we'll see what we got. We'll get a rig on.
Blake, it's your fault.
All right, it's a nice bit of bait on the spot. Probably about a kilo or so out there. And I'm quite confident on both rods. I'm not going to put the third rod out until the morning, maybe. I want to see a fish there, a bit of fizzing. It's right short, right close in here, some pads. It's more of a stalking spot. So instead of keeping it there all night, I want to see some action first. So I'm going to bait it again tonight, bait it again in the morning, hopefully find some fizzing too, then put the rig on the spot. But yeah, the swim's a bit of a mess at the minute. So we're going to tidy that up, have something to eat, then go and catch up with Crowy. He's got his rods out before me. He's got three rods out. So we're going to see where he's got his rods and hopefully see the evening with a couple of fish. But we'll see how it goes. I'm quite a confident foot bite out of here, but I reckon in the morning. Right, we've got one from the hole in the weed. That first rod I put out, and as expected, it's quite solid, but it's coming gradually. I think I might have to get in for this one. That's the problem with this swim, there's a lot of weed. It's gonna be a struggle to actually land them without wading out or getting a boat. But, oh, it'll be all right. At least it's making a holding the weed a bit bigger for me, so when I cast that, it won't take as many attempts with it. Well, better luck next time, that one come off, but there's going to be another chance, and hopefully we'll land this next one. It's all a learning curve, isn't it? Must have been a small one.
What happened with that one?
Oh, it's come off, isn't it, in the weed?
Well, clearly, yeah.
Clearly hook pulled. But there's this weed so thick out here. Drop the lead and all that, but it's going to be a struggle landing one.
That spot looks like where there's carp going to be every single day.
Is that one at the back there?
Yeah, it's just the spot where they're going to come all the time. Yeah.
But I reckon...
James was saying earlier on that yesterday he was out there in the boat and there was fish there, and he spooked him with the boat, and they're back there again today.
Yeah, well, so. My first cast I've learned about earlier, stuck one in the hole, and the bat
stuck one in the hole.
Every hole's a goal.
That's an Essex saying, isn't it?
Every hole's a goal, one of those. Well, stuck it in the hole, and yeah, spoke about 10 fish.
Don't edit that out. Essex banter. Don't let me start you getting that one out, mate. Let's have a look at the cast. Let's see if you can do it first time, then.
I reckon.
Go on, then.
Four attempts.
You're not using a bait bow today. Last time I saw you using a bait bow.
I don't really use bait bows. I bought that for Burfield.
Oh, look, it's landed.
Yeah, a little bit of shout.
Right in the weed.
You've got to be careful because you'll lose the lead and all.
Hey, at least we're doing it properly, though. We're putting that, we're keeping that one on camera. That'd be edited out by some companies. I can see you're under pressure, mate. I'll disappear. See you in a bit.
I do normally get it in the hole every time from Essex, anyway. But the crow was here. The pressure's on.
Bloody hell.
But yeah, watch this. Straight in the hole. One time. Boom, crack, see that? Crowy see it. That was bang on.
So that fish you just lost then, mate, talk us through it. What was it? Did you see it?
Didn't see it. Got in the bite, obviously. You were sitting here.
Yeah.
You see it more than me, because I was in here.
Well, it was a really slow drop back, and then next minute the rod just went...
Well, I got there.
You're on braid though, ain't you? So it's put really violent tape.
But I think because I'm on braid, and it's quite a short range,
yeah,
it's come off straight away pretty much. And where it's so weedy, it was solid straight away.
How deep is it down there where you're fishing?
Well, it's only about 4 foot. I was expecting the fish to just... when it gets hooked, drop the lead, which it did, and come to the top,
yeah,
and then just get it across the weed. But it obviously went straight in the weed.
That looks like it's that really horrible algae though, mate, doesn't it? Where it really just engulfs the fish, and then
you can't
it sort of sticks together, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's like you can't let in, and you can't even get it back.
Yeah.
Like, it's so hard to get back, so I reckon I might borrow the boat out of your swim.
You need your chesties down there, I reckon, mate. Chesties by the rods. As soon as it's, you know, you get a bite, straight into chesties, you're going to have to wade out there, I reckon.
It's going to be a struggle.
Get on top of it as much as you can, because I think they can get out of there. I mean, you can see there's a big clear area in that area. like James was saying, that people have been fishing
it. Yeah, it's one of the known, like, decent swims, people fish it, so they always land them.
There's a lot of fish in there when we got here, so yeah. It doesn't surprise me that that's the rod that's done our first bite. But
I think so. My left-hand rod, that's going to do a bite tonight.
Is it? Where's that one?
Just to the left of the weed, out in open water. Quite a bit of bait around it.
Yeah.
But it's the same situation. When I bring it back, I've got all this weed to get it through. Mm. But if I can let it go out...
Mate, you can get it through that. I fished in Germany only a couple of weeks ago, and I was fishing over weed that was in 30-foot of water. Yeah. Top to bottom, mate.
Did it make it?
Yeah, I lost a few, but I landed most of them. And in this little area here, I'm sure that you'll be able to get them out. It's just about getting... you know, getting on the rods quickly and doing what you're doing, really, fishing with braid and, you know, hitting hold.
Hitting hold.
Sometimes you do lose them,
yeah,
mate.
No stretching that. When you hit and hold, you've got to give me have some, ain't you?
Yeah, yeah.
Pull you up.
Yeah. Of course you have, yeah. You know,
it's some, stretch,
you know, it's weed at the end of the day, and you're never going to always get them out, are you? So, yeah, hopefully we'll get another chance on that rod. I think you will do.
Yeah, I wasn't even expecting it tonight. I was thinking tomorrow morning. So yeah. I'm happy to have got a bite. And there's another one out there now. Behind it, that's like
fish still there.
On your area,
so they're not really spooked.
That's in the sheep zone. That's on your spot.
The sheep zone. Would you?
Yeah, she's coming around my area a bit more.
Hey, I've got. I'm in Duffer's Bay, mate. I've got no carp caught.
I see you there. I casting over earlier.
And casting. Yeah. Well, I've got my three rods out anyway, and I'm happy with them. I've got them over to that big tree. There's a fallen willow on the far bank, and apparently that's where the fish live. Very deep over there, though. It does go down sort of 20 foot just in front of me. It drops off quite quickly.
Mate, you said it was 30 foot in that corner.
Yeah, yeah. Whether it's going to be a rod to do me, I've just seen a fish now roll just in front of you to the left, there, open water.
So that's my left-hand rod there?
Yeah, not a big fish.
That'll
but I just poked his head out.
Get off the mark.
Yeah. Apparently bite time on here as well is mostly during the day, so hopefully we'll see some action tomorrow. So it looks like being a similar sort of weather conditions tomorrow. And first day is always a bit of a settling in time, isn't it? Get to know the spots, get to know the areas.
Letting about and baiting up with that. But tomorrow will be much better.
Yeah, I hope so.
Tomorrow morning, I'm hoping.
I think tomorrow morning is going to be a chance for me and them rods.
I'm confident, looking forward to it.
Bit of deeper water where I am. Then I'm sure they'll come onto this plateau here where you've got here, this weed. That's a perfect sort of time for August, midsummer. Yeah.
See how it goes.
See how it goes, bro. Get back in tune with your carp fishing, eh? Instead of let the head wander.
Let the head wander. Oh,
yeah. You'll be back into it, mate. You never forget it. It's like swimming, isn't it? You just never forget it.
Yeah, I've done an Ellis diary this year. People ask me where my videos are. I've done one, but I've just not edited it.
And
yeah.
Have you not released any this year at all?
Nah.
Not at all.
I think Raised Me Bum was my last one. I've got one from the Manor, Essex Manor.
Yeah.
Just need to edit it.
Yeah, all them banging tunes.
Yeah, all my ghetto music in it.
You get more comments about the music than you do the video.
Yeah, it's like Marmite.
Like, tune bruv days.
You either love it or you hate it, the Ellis Diary.
No, wicked, man. I love them. Nice, light-hearted banter.
Yeah.
That's what carpfishing needs, isn't it?
Realness.
Properness, mate.
Realness.
Yeah, we'll get a bit of that over there.
Yeah, realness.
Next 48 hours, mate, I'm sure. You'll be bantering with me, no doubt. When you get back to normal.
I want one of your Yorkshire coffees again, but I don't know if I can stomach it yet.
He's not his usual self at the minute, but hopefully tomorrow we'll see you. Difference.
See, I'm a bit quiet, you know, compared.
Yeah, you are. Normally you're bantering and calling this, that, and the other.
If I laugh too much, I'm going to get something to have a thought.
Should get the old camera on that one, mate, I reckon. It'd be interesting.
Well, you have already, in there on your Instagram.
Yeah, yeah. Good on there. But
yeah.
I'm sure there's plenty to come with you, mate. There always is. There's always something.
Don't worry,
always a bit of drama.
I'll make it a good time, Chloe.
Good lad.
I'll entertain you.
Good lad. In the hole.
Yeah, in the hole. In the hole.
How's it going?
Not good, mate, really. I've had a tench. That's all I've got to show from the effort so far. Lost a carp as well, which was yeah, smashed to pieces basically, fishing tight to that tree over there.
Looks like we both lost the carp then, eh?
Yeah,
a bit gutted. I'm a bit nervous now. I'm the next bite.
Oh, yeah.
Throw the wage out. If I lose one on any water, I'm always like, I've got to get another bite and try and land it, because it knocks my confidence a bit. Yeah. I think it does everyone, doesn't it?
Well, I've lost one. I'm still pretty confident, but, you know, it's a new lake. We don't know it yet. So I've just got to try and piece the jigsaw together, as always, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, it's always nice to get your first carp from a lake. Adam's got one.
Yeah,
so a little one, only a little baby.
Yeah, you can hit your favourite ones.
Yeah, a little baby fully scaled mirror.
Hanging over them. I don't think I'll land them on my heavy duty gear.
Yeah.
Maybe that's what I lost yesterday, small one.
Yeah, soft mat. Probably a decent one, mate. I've been round to the back of that tree there where I'm fishing to. Yeah.
I've seen a few
decent fish around there, mate. Yeah, there's quite a few. 20 pounders, nice mirrors, so.
My weed bed's a bit quiet this morning.
Yeah.
I was in there last night, like in the afternoon. That's so like I'm open now.
11 o'clock, mate, isn't it?
No? Yeah. So, what time do we get here? At 11, wasn't it?
Yeah, but we didn't get the rods out till probably about 4.
So I'm hoping this afternoon. I was thinking I was going to get one in the morning, like this morning, but it didn't happen.
Yeah.
They just were, they're not in the weed.
How are you feeling today? No, you're all right?
Much better, yeah.
Yeah.
Solid, mate.
No visit?
No, I'm all right.
Yeah, good.
Yeah, I feel I've recovered now.
I ain't feeling bad when you're on the bank, mate.
Yeah, I've recovered now, so it's game on. I'm going to catch a carp or two.
You will do.
They've got to come back.
We all eventually unlock the places, mate, that we fish, so the longer we go into the session, the more we know about the vineyard.
It's not like we've got to move or anything. There's fish here, you know what I mean?
We need to.
The rest of the lake looks pretty dead, doesn't it?
When I was walking the dog this morning, I had a look around, and then bays around there, bit of weed around there, saw some fish, bit of fizzing and that. So it's classic summertime fishing, I think, where the shallow water, that's where the carp are, you know, where there's weed, where there's features.
That's why I think mid-afternoon and onwards, they're going to be back in front of me.
Yeah.
So the rods are out, I'm going to leave them.
Yeah.
Hopefully. I've got like right in that hole in the weed, didn't I?
First time. Yeah. I've got all this deep water out in front of me, and there's just nothing over there. But around the margins, that's where the features are, where the weed is. So again, I said it yesterday. It's mostly not daytime bites on this lake, from what James was telling us. So I'm not surprised that we didn't catch anything during the night. But I got that bite this morning.
At 10 was during the night, wasn't it? Was it first?
No, it was this morning, mate. First light. Yeah, first light this morning. Funny, because I'd not turned the buzzer on. And Adam wandered into the swim. See what, that buzzer's not on. Oh, right. And he turned it on for me. And then literally about 5 minutes later, he's gone, "You're in." What? And not even had a bleep on it. He was filming the actual buzzer itself, and it had dropped back. It not bleeped. And there was a little tench on the end. So, Tenchman Crow. Here comes the planes anyway.
Yeah, well, is there an army base around here?
Yeah, there's typical Lincolnshire, mate. There's airports all over the place.
I saw a couple yesterday fly over.
One of the lakes I fish up the road from here, you see the red arrows all the time, but I think these are all the...
This lake, though, is so out of the way, you'd never find it, would you? It's like, it's just...
No, it's lovely.
Driving here, it's just fields, lanes, and then you've got this lovely...
Yeah, it's a lovely old
lake. Lovely little lake.
Love these old places. Might not be monster carp in here, but there's some really old, ancient fish, which...
It's so grown and mature, like everywhere around, it's just fields, like.
Yeah, always worth catching the old ones.
Yeah.
Anyway, it's getting warm. Time for some dinner, mate.
Yeah, get it on. What are you cooking, mate?
Hey?
What are you cooking?
Nothing. Not for you. You wouldn't like what I eat.
I want one of them Yorkshire coffees one night, yeah.
I ain't having anything off you, anyway, not if you've got the...
No, I've got the lurgy, innit?
The number twos.
No, I'm all right, love. It's game on, I'm going to catch carp. I might have a little wander. Leave you without that little sport about.
All right, dude.
I don't think I'm going to move.
Yeah. All right, geese. See you in a bit, mate. Yeah.
Oh, not again.
Assistance. Well, it's come out of that tree and now it's going right round to the left, so all sorts of features on this lake that can cause you problems. Feature packed lake, fishing locked up, and yeah, it helps, but there's so many other features and obstacles that can cause you problems here. Oh, here we go. Just trying to get into the weeds round to the left. No, so. It's very difficult fishing in this kind of situation and also trying to make a film, because all I'm wanting to do is concentrate on the fish. But Adam is just wanting me to talk to the camera. All this weed down here in the margins to contend with, but looks a nice fish, nice dark one. God, some lovely old carp in this lake. Yes, we've got one. Whew. Bit chaotic, but we've got a carp and we're off the mark, and it looks a nice one as well, so yeah, happy days. God, that was hard work. First one, £20.12, real old bruiser of a carp as well. Probably got lots of stories to tell, and it put up a right old fight as well on that tree line. So what we'll do now is pop him back. We'll have a quick chat about the rig that I'm using to fish in this swing. So anyway, we just put that fish back, and it was a lovely one. Nice old original carp, one of the older strains in the lake, which is always nice, I think, to catch the fish with a bit of history. And what I said is, we're gonna take a look at the rig that I'm using now. Now, I'm not gonna go into the ins and outs of the rig, because if you've seen any of the vlogs on the Avid channel or my own channel, you'd have seen the kind of rigs that I use all the time. But it is very specific, this rig, for the situation that I'm fishing in, because we've seen I'm fishing locked up to the snags on the right-hand side, and obviously there's a bit of distance between where I'm fishing and where the rigs are landing. So I need really tough gear, because these fish, they do fight hard. And obviously, you know what it's like when you snag fishing, you get a few bleeps, you're on the rod, you need to give it a bit of pressure. So what I've got is a size 4 snag armor rock hook, which is really tough, perfect for fishing into really tough snags like we've got here. We've got a little kicker on, and we've got roughly about 8 inches of captive coated hook link on there. Got a lead clip that's only lightly clipped into place as well. Really important when you're fishing in snags. You want to get rid of that lead as much as possible. If the fish is still attached to the lead, it stays deep and it makes it really hard to get that fish out. Whereas if you get rid of the lead, fish comes up in the water, gives you a lot better control over the fish. And I've got roughly about 2.5 rod lengths of 50-pound shock tight leader on there. That is super tough, ideal for fishing in snags, especially snags like this that have got a lot of snails and swan mussels attached to them. Very sharp objects which can easily cut off mono, but with this leader attached, makes it super tough. And that's attached to 15-pound camo outline, which is straight through to the reel. And the rod I'm using today is one of the 3.5-pound Elevate rods. These are new to the range, and I've been using them for quite a while now, and they're absolutely perfect for fishing in snags like this, because they've got some power and they've also got a bit of give as well. You've seen earlier on when I was locked up to that fish, it made it into the snag. Rod was at test curve, but there was still a little bit of bounce there from the fish, which is absolutely ideal in this kind of situation. So it gives you a little bit of control, a little bit of power, but also a little bit of forgiveness for the fish as well. So lovely rods, check them out at your nearest Avid stockist. But that's basically it. Situation is, I've got to get this rod back out there and get it redone, and hopefully we'll catch another carp or two. I just found some carp as I was walking around that were really close in, and they definitely look catchable. So we've been sitting here now for a few hours and nothing's been happening on the static rod. So what I thought I'd do is just set up a float rod, which I've got here. I've got a little bit of corn, which I'll talk to you about in a bit, or a bit of maize, I should say. And I'm gonna go around there and see if we can catch one. So follow me. It's loads of brambles everywhere. Seen some apples as well and some plums. Not just me that likes these, the old dog likes them. Oi, come here. Here you go. The dogs like brambles. Tasty. This is the spot, but obviously I've got a dog and you know what dogs are like. They go straight in the water, spook all the fish off. So I've got to try and keep her away from doing that. So I'm going to tie her up the back of the swim and get in behind one of those trees because it offers a nice bit of cover. So let's try and creep in there. Great dog. This is when everything can go wrong. You fall over brambles here. Get the net stuck on brambles. But these fish are really close in down here. And they're fizzing just down there. But obviously, I've got a big rod. I've got a 12-foot rod, so I'm not going to be able to just poke it through that little bush. I'm going to have to fish from this side of the tree. See if I can coax the fish out of there. So let's get set up anyway. I'm not putting in much bait, just a little bit. Maize. The reason I'm using maize is because it's nice and bright. So fish just gone right underneath that there. I don't know if I've spooked it. The maize is nice and bright and this water's quite murky. There's a fish going down on it straight away. Gosh. I don't think it's gone down on the bait, but it's gone down in the air. So, I don't think, I'm not bigging myself up here, Rick, and I don't think it's going to take us very long to get a bite out of here, but whether I get it in or not is another question. Cool, yeah, that's fizzing, that's coming off the bait, that is. It's a hit and hold spot, like I said. I've got top gear. Let's hope it holds. Real hit and hold stuff. Very cramped in the edge here. But, oh, quite a decent fish as well, lads. Yes. With a bit of help with Adam, we got him in the net. But that is exciting, really exciting. Just move that out of the way of the lens. That's a nice fish. What is it, half an hour in the right spot and you get one. So yeah, heart's going a bit at the minute, but we've got another fish, so great stuff. Bit out of breath at the minute. That's how exciting carp fishing can be, especially in little small areas like that. A bit of float fishing for 15, 20 minutes or so. And we've got this lovely little mirror, so happy days. What are you saying, dog? Lovely memories. Thank you for the memories. What a great little half an hour that was.
Well, you look happy. What have you been up to?
All right. Yeah, just having a little bit of a stalk, mate, down there. There was a load of fish around in the bay. Went to walk the dog.
Yeah, I've seen
a few around there, yeah. And took a bit of maize that I found. You wouldn't believe it. Just found it in the margins. And these were bright and yellow.
It was already in the lake?
Yeah.
Normally scooped it out?
Yeah. Yeah. Normally I carry a tin of sweet corn with me, but I used it the other day and I've not been to Morrison's to get any more. So there was a load of maize in the margins.
That's been there.
I don't know how long it's been there, and I just scooped it all up, bright yellow stuff, perfect for a little stalking spot around there, and dropped a bit on it. They kept coming in and circling up. There was twigs and bits coming off the bottom. There's a few good fish down there, if I'm honest. There's a few 20 pounders. But
I saw a 20 earlier, and I saw a tiny one in that little gap.
Did you? Yeah.
I was going to go around there before I leave it. I might try it tomorrow because it's been quiet out here.
Yeah. There was a good dozen fish around there, mate. A couple of ghosties that were 20 pound, I'd have said, somewhere around that. Nice big yellow belly one. It weren't the big one, but it was a good fish, real good fish. But
well done.
In a tight little space like that with a 12-foot rod. Not the perfect kind of situation, but managed to get it in. So exciting, mate. So I've got the static rods back out now, just redone them.
I've got one floating about in my hole at the minute.
I've just seen it, mate.
Yeah, it's back out.
It's a good fish as well, that is over there.
Yeah. So that's
is that the spot
one.
Where you lost that fish yesterday?
Yeah, it's the first one I've seen all day in the weeds. So I'm hoping where you've had that one from around there.
Yeah.
Because there's quite a few fish around there, weren't there?
Yeah.
I'm hoping you've pushed them out and that's just appeared.
Yeah.
So fingers crossed, we'll get a bite.
Mate, that's a good length of fish that is.
It's got a good length on it.
Yeah, good length. What are you like?
It's a good fish, mate, anyway.
Yeah. So it is a good fish. So let's hope we see it on the bank.
Yeah, oh, there it is.
Yeah, that's a tail out there. Yeah, that was the tail of it, yeah.
Just that's going down on my base.
Could be. Be nice, you've got one toner now. Anyway, hungry work, mate, that was, so I need some food. So
yeah, I'm going to sit here. Sit here on my hands because I feel that might go in a minute.
Yeah, I think you're in with a good shout there, mate.
I'm due one now, aren't I?
Yeah, definitely.
Well done, son.
See you in a bit, mate.
Today, on.
Bit of a chaotic fight this one because literally just put the rod out and getting ready to get some breakfast and it went and it stopped me right in the snag. So Adam came round, he held the rod, I went out in the boat to free it and somehow I got out of the snag and now we've got it just down here, so it's ready for netting. So what I'm basically trying to say is, when they get in the snags, they're not always lost, especially when you've got a boat to hand. Let's see if we can get the fish out first, out of this weed. Little mirror that's good old scrapper. Come on, you. Let's see if we can get you in finally, after all this. Guy don't want to come in, does he? Now he's stuck there. Oh. Right, we're in. Yep, we're in. Poor little fish. Poor little... Hey. Right, we got it. After all that, bit of teamwork. Thanks to Greg, it looks like he's just got up. Thanks to Adam. So, another carp anyway. Well, there you go. There's that fish we've just landed a few moments ago. Proper old battle out in the boat, snagged up at first, but thanks to a bit of teamwork. Gregster, do you want to get on this, mate?
Yeah.
You help me just as much as, well, we can't get Adam in because he's looking after the camera, but thanks to these guys, we got it in the end. Lovely old fish, and yeah, nice start to the morning. Just put a bit of fresh bait out. This one's actually just been out for about half an hour and then we've got a bite, so I think that's the third fish we've had now when I've put some fresh bait out and we've had a bite. Only a short while afterwards, time well, for a bit of bait, mate.
Welcome to the Simon Crowe Show. So with you saying that, I think I'm going to get my rods out, reel them in, fresh bait, and hopefully I'll get a bite, because at the minute, it's not really happening. I'm struggling.
You'll get a bigger, mate, knowing you.
Struggling. I reckon I'll pull a big one out at the end, hopefully. But yeah, well done. Good angling.
Nice one, dude.
After seeing Crowe's fish and he caught out after a recast and a fresh bit of bait, I thought, I've got to bring my rods in, give two rods a recast, new bit of bait, and hopefully I'll get a bite. I'm getting pretty desperate now. It's pretty quiet out there. Well, I have seen a couple of fish down open water, so a rechuck, hopefully it brings something on, because at the minute it's quiet in my swim, and it's not happening. So let's get this out there, see what we get.
With Cray's fish returned and my rods repositioned, we both stood there watching the water as drizzle filled the air, and expectations were high. Despite our hopes, the rest of the morning passed uneventfully into the afternoon.
It was a beautiful summer's day on a wonderful carp water, and there was loads of carp on show. And in the afternoon, myself and Greg decided we were going to have a little bit of a stalk to see if we could catch a carp or two, but nothing came our way. So in the evening, once we got the rods out, we settled down with a cup of tea in hand, chatted away the evening, and settled back, seeing if anything happened during the night.
Good morning. Another quiet night for me. Looks like a blank could be on the cards, but Crowe's got another one by the looks of it. So fingers crossed, they'll buy it on my side. But at the minute, it's been such a tough session. Crowe's showing me up. It's definitely a Simon Crowe show, and it's not happening for the Ellis. But hopefully, we've got a couple more hours, and hopefully they go. But I'm not feeling that confident, to be fair. If I was going to have one, I would have one by now, and it's not happening. So fingers crossed, time will tell. Lovely common this time then.
Yeah, £17 common, mate, so, or thereabouts.
Nice.
Yeah, doing all right on that side.
It's not really happening for me this session, is it?
Mate, you're not your usual self, I'll say that.
Really?
Last year when we fished at Little Farriers, you was walking, doing what I'm doing, basically.
Walking about, trying to make it happen.
Yeah, trying to make it happen. I can tell you're not your usual self. You've got that bug from Turkey that you brought.
Yeah, my sister sent me a message last night, travel warning to Turkey, like salmonella and that, and I think I've got that.
Yeah.
Because
yeah,
I still ain't right.
Yeah.
So, and it says it lasts a week.
Yeah.
So you're lucky I've actually come to grace your presence.
Hey, I'm happy you're here. You're still your joking self, though.
I just ain't got the energy and the drive, you know?
You're not into your fishing at the minute.
Oh.
You're loved up for a start off.
Yeah, I've got the bug and lost the bug.
It always affects you when you get loved up, you know that. But you know, you could have draw for swims is an important thing as well, isn't it, mate? Sometimes you make the wrong decisions, we all do, you know, and you could have gone on that side, you'd have probably caught what I've caught.
Yeah.
Maybe even more than that, you'd have caught more.
But I actually wanted that side. Like, you gave me the choice and I chose that. I wanted the weed, there was fishing there.
Like, you know, I fancied that side as well, if I'd had the choice.
I thought you fancied that side, because when you come here, you're like, that's a spot. You'd done a bit of research, and I thought, you want that.
No, the two swims that they told me about was your swim, the two picnic table swims.
Yeah.
One's called picnic table point, one's called picnic.
You can always swap for an hour if you want.
Right, it's...
nice chance to load
in
all that.
In front of you though, isn't they? They're just not picking
That's
up.
The thing, they've been there.
Yeah.
But I've been using plastic hook baits. I love my plastic. I glug them in a special liquid, and they're deadly everywhere. It's what I call the Burfield common on. All my carp, big carp I catch, are on these plastics.
Yeah.
But where I've caught a bite, I've had a bite and lost it in the weed.
Yeah.
It's not happened.
Yeah.
Maybe I should have used pop-ups, real ones, or bottom baits. I've not changed.
Decisions are always the things that go through your mind whenever you're on a session, isn't it? You're driving home and I should have done this, should have tried the other, should have done whatever, you know. And it's ultimately, I think, though, mate, if you'd have gone on the side where I am, you'd have caught fish. You just, you know, we're both decent. You know,
but there's fish out there. They're all over me. I can't get a bite. There's a problem. I know there's a problem.
Yeah.
And I reckon I should have had a bit more energy, showed a bit more effort.
You'd have stalk fish in the margins like I did. You know, the other day I picked that one off in the margins yesterday afternoon. I went over there and found some fish.
Blanks, mate, it happens to the best of us, doesn't it? And this could be a three-night
blank.
You're
not lacking confidence, as you. You're like...
I've got the confidence, but I'll tell you what, not with confidence.
Yeah.
Losing that first bite out in the weed.
You lost confidence.
I lose confidence. If I say I'm on a lake and I get a hook pole, right, I'm paranoid then, and my confidence gets lowered massively because I'm worried about my next bite, and I'm worried that I'm not going to land it. And 9 times out of 10, I'll get another hook pole. Mm. So now, if I get a bite now, I ain't landing it. I know it. It's going to get weeded. That's the way I think. My brain, I can tell my brain things and it happens,
right?
Especially in fishing.
No wonder they cyberbully you then online.
Yeah, I get abused, don't I? But I can handle that now. Burfield Common cyberbullying, that was harsh.
I never lack confidence when I'm fishing, ever. You know, sometimes...
Not even if you lose one. Do you not think, I've got to get the next one in?
Yeah, you do, but you don't lack confidence in it. But I always think that I'm going to get the next one in. Even if I lose it, I never lack confidence.
If something bad happens, I'm waiting for it to happen again.
Yeah, that's a damn.
And then I need to get one, land it, and then I won't be as... I'll be confident again then, as soon as I land one.
You're a successful enough carp angler to get fish from this swim easy.
Yeah, but it's the brain. It's the brain does some overthinking, doesn't it? It's all about, if I tell myself I'm going to do well, I'll do well. If I tell myself I'm not going to do well, like this session, it ain't happening. It won't.
Yeah. Well, you said
I can tell the future.
I could tell right at the beginning of the session.
I can tell the future in things, yeah.
You can tell the future.
Yeah, I can tell, like
Frank Warwick,
I could tell that I weren't going to do well this session, from the start, since that loss.
Yeah.
And it's just affected me, I think.
Just go along with the flow, mate. If you get in the swim, just make your most out of it. That's all I do. You know, and there's fish both sides, you know, but you know what carp fishing's like. Sometimes they pick up from one side, they don't pick up from the other.
I told myself I was going to catch the Burfield Common, and I told you at that hotel in Manchester, wasn't it?
I said,
I'm going to catch that.
Yeah,
he was like, don't waste your time. I'm like, I'm going to do it.
Yeah.
I had so much confidence.
You did. Yeah.
If I went on there and I was like, I ain't going to catch that, it's too hard, I'd still be there now.
Yeah.
Like, I need to tell myself things, and I've told myself straight away on this trip that I'm going to blank.
Mate, it's just, Burfield Common was 3 years ago.
Yeah.
4 years ago.
And it still affects me now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it's been a good session either way, mate. So, you know, let's take a look at this £70 that I've had down there. And how long we've got left now? Probably about 4 hours of the session left. My confidence is different to yours, and it wouldn't surprise me if you ended up catching a fish from that side.
Really, I don't normally pull one out of the bag last login, so it is...
Wouldn't surprise me.
It's last chance soon, it could happen, but I've got to think positive, and I can't.
Let's have a look at this fish, common this time, which is nice. Breaks up the mirrors, but had it just before first light, so a nice way to start the morning. Most of my bites have been coming off that no fishing bank, which is a really big feature on a lake like this because there's no swims down to the right in the corner. And if you've got that kind of feature on any lake, generally they're pretty good spots. So it doesn't surprise me that's been the most productive one, but we've still got 3 or 4 hours left of the session. So let's get this one back. And the morning so far have definitely been better than the nights, so there's always a chance before pack up time. Gregster, it's been a nice little session, you know, on a beautiful venue as well. It's good to catch up with you. I know fishing's been a little bit tricky and that. You ain't been feeling your normal self.
No, I've been here when I've been a bit rough, so I've not been on the ball like I usually am.
Yeah.
As you can tell, you've noticed.
Yeah. But
it's fish
nice,
out there
now. Nice seeing you though, mate. It is.
Yeah.
You know,
I've reeled in and there's fish all over me.
Fishing,
I know there's
mate.
Pressure there. They know I'm from Essex, don't they?
You know what fishing's like, mate. But it's been good seeing you, mate. Anyway, hopefully next time I see you, you'll be in
in full spirits again. And
I'll be better then.
Yeah, you'll have a six pack instead of a four pack.
Yeah. Lost a bit of weight this week.
Have you? Yeah. I'm not surprised actually the amount of times you've been to the toilet. Anyway, it's been lovely down on here in this venue. And if anybody's interested in fishing this venue, then obviously it's Stickney Brick Pit. It's an exclusive lake only that you can book for up to 8 anglers. And there's full details on the website. But thank you for James for inviting us down here. So yeah, lovely to see you, dude.
And you.
Yeah.
If you like this video, don't forget to click the like button, subscribe to the channel, and click the notification bell. And we'll see you next time around.